And this is our first track from our guest today, Richie Henderson.
Since you've not been around, seen as how my life's been rearranged. I put my hand up, but you said you didn't want it. I would have given anything. You said I love you, though your mind just wasn't on it. What a feat for a king! What a feat for a king! 3 o'clock in the
Richie Henderson.
What a feat for a...
From his days way back when, in the Liberties. Good afternoon, Rich.
Hello there, Mark. How are you?
I'm absolutely fantastic. Oh. What a lovely day. Thank you for joining us. Struggling through the traffic to get here. Yeah. So I'll do your formal introduction. You're Richie Henderson. You're an Edinburgh singer, songwriter,
yeah,
and regular performer round Edinburgh. I'm going to actually take you right back, Richie.
Okay.
Yeah, which might be a couple of years ago, but I'm going to take you way back to when it all started for you. Tell us how your interest in music developed.
Fortunately, I was born in the 50s. Mm-hmm. Best decade ever to be born in, because you caught all the stuff. You know, you caught your post-war stuff.
Yeah.
Beatles, Elvis, the whole lot, and I was hooked when I saw the Beatles on telly in 1963 on a program. I was mesmerised,
uh-huh,
totally mesmerised, and I thought, I want to do that. I want to be a pop star.
Yeah, I mean,
as we all did at that age, you know. So it was just a fan of songs and and music, and my parents were big lovers of, mm-hmm, songs. Jim Reeves, Sinatra, Shirley Bassey, Matt Monro, the whole lot. So we, Roy and I, sort of grew up on that training, if you like. We always had music in the house.
I mean, I've quite often said to people as well that my influences, or I suppose people's influences when you're young, is dictated by your parents' record collection.
Yep.
You know, because you're too young to buy records yourself, and you've only got a certain amount of records in the house, so their tastes are obviously you know, rolled onto you.
And my folks didn't approve of some of our stuff, you know, Rolling Stones and Beatles and stuff like that. It took them years to come around to actually saying that they liked McCartney, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just went from there. And then formed the band with Roy years ago in 77, I think it was, long time ago, called Hotel. Crap, but great fun, you know, our learning curve.
Yep.
And did all the clubs and stuff like that. Then it went from there. Roy and I's paths split, as these things do, you know, family stuff. And but we both kept doing it, and it wasn't until the 80s I got into seriously, packed in my jobs and stuff like that, and just played music.
It's that bold move. It's that, you know, that when you make that decision to say, right, okay, I'm going to immerse myself full time in this and really take the chance. And generally, you know, I found that people say, you know, there's a bit of resistance when you do that, from family and friends saying, are you sure you're doing the right thing?
Well, my mum was horrified when I packed in my job at, in the civil service, you know, all those years ago. I said, oh, think about your pension, son. Pensions weren't, at that age, I wasn't interested in a pension, you know. I just wanted to sing songs, so I did. And I've been lucky, you know. I've had my breaks and stuff like that, and I've seen places, and I've worked with some great folk, some of the best players in the city, so
yep.
I'm really proud of that.
Now, we played that first track there, from the band, The Liberties.
Yeah, Liberties.
And you said to me off air, just as we were putting the track on, that was your one crack at fame.
It was a chance, you know. I wanted to be in a group. I wanted to be on telly. I wanted to make records. I wanted to tour. I wanted all the trappings and all the bad behaviour with it. And there was a lot of that, and it was great fun, but I saw a side of the industry which I just didn't like much.
Mm-hmm.
And we only existed for about 18 months.
Yeah.
We didn't have the chance to do the second album because Manchester happened. And that blew everything out of the window and water in the early 90s. Happy Mondays, Stone Roses, all that stuff. That sort of kicked us all out the window. And the industry changed quickly. And too much money was getting wasted in the industry at that time, you know. And I think we were the last major signing up here anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And we were the first out.
Well, it sometimes happens that way.
It was great fun, you know.
Yeah.
We worked with so many good folk. We did tours with Katie Lang, Nancy Griffiths, Lyle Lovett, all this stuff.
Yeah.
Richard Thompson,
mm-hmm.
blah, blah, blah. And it was just, it's something good to have on your CV.
Yes, definitely.
So I've got no regrets about it whatsoever.
Ah, good. So. Now, we're keen to try and get as much music in as possible.
Sure.
You're going to give us a wee live tune.
I will do, yeah. Hold on, I'll just have a wee slurp of water because
it's very warm in
here. It's hot out there.
It's hot out there. It's very warm in here as well.
Okay, okay.
So what are you going to give us, Roy?
Well,
Roy's
that's
terrible. Richie, just for the benefit of the listeners, your brother is Roy Henderson, who is no stranger to the station here at Black Diamond.
That's right. I mentioned the second album, which we didn't make, but this is a song that was planned for the second album. Mm-hmm. I wrote this with Stuart Nisbet, and we decided to go into cheese mode. So it's a wee song called Santiago Town.
Lovely.
Hope I remember it. It might help if I played it in the right key, right enough. Hold on. Yeah.
Generally helps.
There's a path running down to meet the waterfront, and a light that breaks the evening air. As we stand across the bay, it carries us away. So we'll stay in Santiago Town. You can hear what they're saying on a crowded street. When the fingers point, they turn and stare. What's been hidden in the past, neglected and outcast, we know at last in Santiago Town. There's really no point in hiding ourselves from these strangers, but read all about it from pillar to post. We've got to brace up to the dangers. Santiago Town. There's really no point in hiding ourselves from these strangers. We'll read all about it from pillar to post. We've got to face up to the dangers. When we fly to find out what's awaiting us, will we see each other anymore? Underneath the setting sun, a new life's just begun. We two are one in Santiago Town. Underneath the setting sun, a new life's just begun. Two are one in Santiago Town.
Rich. Absolutely great stuff from Richie. We'll be back after playing a little bit of With Us.
Quiet on the sidewalk, the fall of New York, where the passers-by keep passing all around the clock. The locomotives rumble high above. They won't admit it, but this city's in love. Will you still be on the page? come. They'll be pulling down the eyelids and waking all the bums. But they only need a gentle shove. They won't admit it, but the city's in love. Perfection, though we may be nowhere near it, maybe we should all start screaming. I wonder, can you hear it?
And that's the second track, second recorded track from the Liberties, Richie Henderson. Great stuff, Richie. Mm. It must bring back memories when you listen back to some of these tracks.
It does. I couldn't actually listen to the album for years afterwards,
mm-hmm.
Because I'd heard it so much, toured it so hard.
Yeah.
Same songs every night in the same order, and I just had to stop playing it at home.
Yeah.
So it's in my past, but I'm very proud of it. So,
you're still a very prolific performer around the Edinburgh
scene.
Yeah,
I'm still doing it, still getting away with it.
A lovely term.
No, it's good. I get regular work all over the city.
Mm-hmm.
I lose some, I get some. You know, it swings from around the world. And right now it's fairly busy just now with the Fringe and stuff like that.
And it's a mixture of stuff. It's a mixture of covers, your own personal tastes, and original songs that you write as well.
Occasionally, so, yeah.
And you've been writing for many years. How did the songwriting start? How did that come about?
I dabbled with it when I was in the first band with Roy, actually, Hotel, all those years ago, and we wrote two or three songs ourselves, and it just grew, and it's something that we liked to do.
Yeah,
and it somehow it just came to us because we both know songs in our heads so well. You sometimes pinch bits of songs and like assemble.
Remember, this has been recorded.
Pinch bits of everybody does it. You know, it's an old trick. And, you know, we grew up with songwriters as well. Lennon McCartney was a huge influence on me anyway. And folk like Elton John, huge fan of his in the 70s. And more recently, folk like Elvis Costello, Ron Sexsmith,
mm-hmm.
top writers, Randy Newman.
Yeah.
psychology stuff, you know.
And what influences the songwriting then? Is it life events, or is it, you know, do you sit down and say, right, I'm going to write a song about a dog running away?
I never plan a song, and I never have. I've always done it. If you kind of grab the listener's attention in the first 15 seconds of a song, then it doesn't work. So you have to make it instant. And I used to work from the formula of verse, hook, verse, hook, bridge, hook, fade out, you know. But I recently I've been sort of juggling that formula about a bit. Mm-hmm. But as long as it's a strong melody, and then words just come into your head somehow. And
funnily enough, I was listening.
It's weird.
I was listening to an interview that Lulu gave yesterday with Steve Wright on Radio 2. She's released a new album. It's all songs that she's written. But she was saying that just exactly what you're saying about the melody and the hook, mm-hmm. and you know, the middle eight and changing up. But she learned that, obviously, because she was married to one of the Bee Gees. And they three guys would just get up in the morning, get the coffee out, and then sit and get the guitars out. And plan.
Songs of those boys, yeah. As well, she was lucky. She had was kind of surrounding herself with good songwriters as well.
Mm. Yep.
And she handpicked a lot of her stuff. She handpicked folk like Neil Diamond in the 60s and stuff like that. And then Bowie in the 70s.
Yeah.
So she knew, she's smart.
Uh-huh.
And so that's how songs hit me anyway. I don't have a magic sort of wand and write a song. So many folk can just churn out songs constantly. I can't do that.
But I can see when you're talking about it, though, Richie, I can see the passion that you obviously put into it.
Yeah,
you still feel it.
I'd rather write six or seven really good songs that I'm happy with than write 40 so-so songs, you know.
Well, give us one of your six or seven really good ones.
Well, I'm not saying it's really good, but it's a song I've been sort of dabbling with for the last wee while, and I recorded a thumbnail a version of this with Davey Payton,
uh-huh.
about 10 years ago, and it's just a demo at home, and I didn't use it, but thinking, I might actually start using it. Yeah. It's called Another Moon. You've got it bad, girl. You got what you want, then you shiver inside through the summer. Why didn't I see it coming a mile down the road that'll take us to nowhere fast? Where there's a will, you'll find a way. Where there's a night, you'll find a day. But it don't sun, you want another moon. Look in my eyes, they're not close to the light. Maybe they're not the same ones you wanted. Disappoint, it's a miniature world, baby. Take what you have, try to flaunt it. Where there's a will, you'll find a way. Where there's a night, you'll find a day. But it don't
Well, there's a will, you'll find a way. Where there's a night, you'll find a day. But it don't really matter anyway. You want a son, you want another son. You want another son.
Back with Richie after a little bit of Paul.
Your very own Mr. Entertainment, Mark Mulgrew on 107.8 Black Diamond FM.
I leave the home of a lifetime like any son. I have hope and good intentions. Wandering into the daybreak, I learn as I go. To fall laughing into the water. Sticks and the stones are your broken promises. I wait.
Tune from my guest Richie Henderson. Great stuff, Rich.
Thank you.
You tell me that takes you back to around about 1989.
89, that was recorded. That was actually the demo that we did for Rags to Riches, written by the wonderful Blue Nile. And I actually think that's better than the album version. Mm-hmm. But so I chose that one.
You chose that one.
I chose that
one.
Yeah.
Now you've been in the music game for a lot of years. And
yeah, too many.
And you're still gigging. Still and this is my now infamous question that I always ask everybody. Mm-hmm. What advice would you give anybody who was looking to get into this? You took that bold move back in the 80s to go full time.
Oh, God.
What advice would you give, Richie?
It's changed so much. The industry has changed dramatically. The audiences have changed. I really don't. The only advice I would give is just listen to songs, learn songs. Mm-hmm. Don't try to be a pop star, for God's sake. You don't want to go down that road, I don't think. But if you play something, be good at it. And if you write, be good at it as well, and just hammer out, just go out there and do it. Venues are somehow dwindling slightly in this city anyway. Mm-hmm. And the live music scene is changing generally. You have the whole noise issue and all this stuff like that. Somebody buys a flat next to a bar and then shouts about noise, you know. And that's unfortunate, but it's true, that's happening. But I would say, yeah, just keep doing it and don't listen to anybody but yourself. Just follow your dreams.
Just go out there and enjoy it.
Follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
And occasionally make some money.
If you can, good luck to you.
There's loads and loads of these pictures that go about in social media, but the one that always gets me is, if you want to make money, don't become a musician.
Become a dentist or a lawyer or a plumber. You can make money as a musician if you're a good session player and you're a bit of a hired hand. Uh-huh. But if you're a solo singer-songwriter, be careful. Yeah.
So where can people see you? You've got some regular gigs.
Well, yeah, regular-wise, I've got things on in the Fringe, random gigs, mostly down at the Cowgate and the High Street, at the Tron Kirk, mm-hmm. Roy, on the, I think it's the 31st of August, at the Cowshed, and St James's Gate. I don't have dates on me.
All of these can be found on the Facebook pages for the Tron listings.
Yeah, it's on the Facebook stuff. Next Friday, we do two regular Fringe gigs at the Guildford Arms, uh-huh. behind what used to be Woolworths at the east end of Princess Street.
Just at West Register Street, yep.
Next Friday, it's the Caledonian Brewery. Can I see that?
Yes, you can see that. Okay. They sponsor it. It's Caledonian Brewery Beer Festival, is it?
Yeah. It's the Jazz and Blues Festival. We're not jazz or blues, but hey.
So take a gig, though.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's 8:30 next Friday night. My mate, who I usually do it with, Bert, he's actually broke his foot. So he's out of action for next week. So Roy's going to do it with me. So it'll be a Henderson Brothers.
Always handy.
Extravaganza.
Handy having a brother that you can rely on.
It's strange, eh?
Now, you're going to give us one wee final tune before before we take it up to the news.
Sure.
What are you going to give us?
Right. I'm going to do a song that I love. Written by a guy called Sandy Wright, who comes from Pathead. He's written some wonderful songs, and this is one of them. It's called Shining Star. Okay.
While the storm is raging, the sky turned black. Your light came to me in a bar, and it brought me to my journey's end. You are my shining star. Can I stay with you, my
shining star. Everything that I am seems to be where you are. But the sun is eclipsed, and here you are. You are my shining star. Can I stay with you, my shining star? Everything that I am seems to be where you are. Though the sun is eclipsed, and here you are. You are my shining star. Can I stay with you, my shining star? Everything that I am seems to be where you are. But the sun is eclipsed, and here you are. You are my shining. You are my shining. You are my shining star.
Richie Henderson, great live session, great chat, Richie.
Thank you very much, Mark.
Taking us up to the news in about 30 seconds. It just leaves me to say thank you very much for taking the time.
Oh, you're welcome. No, thank you.
And enjoy the rest of your gigs. And,
I will. I'll try to.
If people want to pop down and see you, just have a look for the listings for the Tronkirk and for what's happening at the Cowshed down at the Cowgate. And once again, Richie, thanks very much.
It's been
an absolute pleasure.
No worries.
Coming up after the news, around about 10 past two, I'm going to be chatting to my...